Heck no, man. You learn to give people a look that, like, you know, get away or just, you know, like, nah, man.
Staring, be careful, the idle mind is a dangerous place to be left in, but keep your eyes on me. Yeah, your heart don't stand a chance.
As we come on the air this Sunday night, America is just now coming to grips with what unfolded here in the early morning hours here in Orlando, a massacre at a gay nightclub right here behind me. You can see the sign, it's black and white, just over my shoulder here. And at the center of it all, a lone gunman. Authorities say the shooter, revealed to be 29-year-old Omar Mateen, a U.S. citizen born in America with Afghani parents. Police say he used two guns. Authorities revealing he purchased the guns in recent days.
This incident is going to be investigated impartially, professionally, and thoroughly by the United States Department of Justice.
He is the oldest division. Of his siblings. Hopefully, he is 15 years old.
Understands that. The tensions will ease.
He had to watch this.
To press for calm
and this was put all over.
And that's what I'm asking for right now.
Out, let.
Stay with me. We got pulled over for a busted tail light in the back. And the police just, he's covered. He killed my boyfriend. He's licensed to carry.
I'm Nadeska Alexis for Complex News, and what you just watched was disturbing footage from Falcon Heights, Minnesota, where a 32-year-old black man named Philando Castile was shot and killed by a police officer during a traffic stop on Wednesday night, while his distraught girlfriend live-streamed the incident on Facebook from the passenger seat, and her 4-year-old daughter watched from the backseat of the car. Just 24 hours ago, we were struggling to cope with
breaking
the gruesome
news,
footage
of two
Baton Rouge police officers
in
using
at least two snipers opening
and
fire
and
in downtown Dallas during a rally against the fatal police shootings of black men in Louisiana and in Minnesota in recent days. The snipers hit 11 police officers, at least five of whom are now dead, making it the deadliest day in law enforcement since September 11th.
Johnson
had written manifestos on how to shoot, move.
He said he was upset about the recent police shootings. The suspect said he was upset at white people. The suspect stated he wanted to kill white people, especially white officers.
Debate over race and law enforcement.
Overnight, large street demonstrations have been going on in cities across our country.
God help America.
The protest movement against fatal police shootings of black people is not slowing down, even after the events in Dallas.
On Tuesday, President Obama spoke in Dallas at a memorial service for the five Dallas police officers killed by a sniper. The shooter, Micah Johnson, opened fire at the end of an anti-police brutality march, killing five officers and wounding at least seven more. Obama urged the nation to reject despair, saying the country is not as divided as it may seem.
I know that Americans are struggling right now with what we've witnessed over the past week. First, the shootings in Minnesota and Baton Rouge, the protests, then the targeting of police by the shooter here. An act not just of demented violence, but of racial hatred. All of it's left us wounded and angry and hurt. It's as if the deepest fault lines of our democracy have suddenly been exposed, perhaps even widened.
Because it's too late for a lot of people, and that's why it's about, it's not about right now. It's about when we all dead and gone.
kind of in the wake of the fatal police shooting of Alton Sterling in Baton Rouge, Louisiana, and Philando Castile in Falcon Heights, Minnesota. Today we look at a side of the Baton Rouge story that has received little attention. What has happened to the individuals who filmed and distributed the shocking videos of Alton Sterling's death? The video shows a Baton Rouge police officer pinning Sterling together. Solving problems and the
projects around the world. I want people to feel the fear of being 12, 13 years old when your best friend's dad goes to jail and leaves guns. You go on YouTube to figure out how to use it. The fear that we understood that we had, that is the mood and the tone of this album. Because that's real. They're just troublemakers. No. It's a result of you not camping. That's what summertime signifies. It's when I understood the power of fear.
You gotta keep your guard, you gotta be tough. You know what I'm saying? Depends on what situation you're in or where you're at. You know what I'm saying?
Fed up with the sunshine, fed up with the gun violence, fed up with the old rules, fed up with the young dying. I just wanna live forever. 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 Fed up with the song singing, fed up with the gang banging. Fed up with the same things. Fed up with my life changing. I just wanna show you better. I just wanna show you better. I just wanna show you better. I just wanna show you better.